Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make this lotus flower bookmark. And if you've followed my channel since the beginning, you'll probably remember my first ever tutorial was a tree of life bookmark. I've learned a lot about filming, editing, and producing better quality tutorials since then, so I wanted to film a better version of the bookmark video. So if you'd like to see a better, clearer, higher quality version of this process, stay tuned. I'm starting with a piece of 18 gauge square dead soft copper wire, and it's 14 inches long, and I'm going to mark my wire right in the center with a dry erase marker, and this will just help me with positioning it on my mandrel. And I'll be using a square shaped mandrel for this bookmark. And I'm wanting my frame to be a rhombus rather than a square, so I'm placing the center of my wire on one of the corners and I'll start bending there. And then holding my wire firmly to the mandrel, I'll gently twist it together. Then I'll just take some nylon pliers and even this out. Now I can start hammering my bookmark, and I'll be starting with the little frame. Okay, before I can hammer the rest, I need to bend it first, and I'll be doing that with baling pliers. Now I can hammer the part that will slide into the book, and I'm placing it right on the edge of my steel bench block and holding it still with two fingers. And I'm going slow right here at the top because I don't want to accidentally hit my little frame and warp it. Also, watch your fingers because it's easy to accidentally smash one if you're not paying attention.
And just FYI, you don't have to hammer your bookmark. I personally like the look of the hammered twisted wire, and it stiffens the wire and makes it better suited for being shoved in and pulled out of books on a regular basis. But if you don't have the supplies to hammer it, it's not a huge deal. Just don't use any gauge thinner than 18. And before I finish hammering the end, I want to form two little loops down here. Okay, so that's our frame, and now we can make the lotus flower. I'm using a piece of 18 gauge round dead soft copper wire, and it's 8 inches long, and I'll just bend it in the center here. And I'm going to gently squeeze the end just a little. Then I can pull that apart a little bit and start shaping the center petal. And I like to use a mandrel or baling pliers to get this first petal nice and evenly shaped. Once I've got my central petal formed, I can start forming the next one. I'll just bring this side of my wire up parallel to my first petal. And I'm going to put a little bend up here, and then I'll use the tip of my bent chain nose pliers to form the tip of the next petal. And just like with the first petal, I want to gently squeeze the tip of this one before I stretch it out a little bit and start curving it downward. And now I'll do the same on the other side. As I finish the last two petals, I'll check the size of my flower against the frame. And just to give credit where it's due, I learned the basics of this lotus flower design from the incredibly talented Lan An Handmade. I've added my own spin to it, but her work is definitely the inspiration, and I really appreciate her tutorials, so I just need to give her a little shout out. All right, there's our flower. And now we can start a little woven embellishment and add a bead. I'm using 26 gauge round wire, and this piece is about 15 inches long. And I'm going to start with just two coils on this inner petal. and then I'll do two coils on the other side. And I'll repeat that twice and then add my bead. I'm going to snip this tail off up here and then tuck this wire in. And this is a 3 millimeter bead that I'm using. And I'll just gently tighten this weaving wire around the base wire and continue coiling with the 2-2 weave. I'm going to check against my frame real quick and see how much more I should weave. And I can weave a little further here. Okay, that's good. Now I'm going to snip off my weaving wire and tuck it in. And then I'll finish these with some loops. Okay, now we can attach the flower to the frame. I'm using another piece of 26 gauge round wire, and it's around 24 inches long. I'm threading this weaving wire through my two loops at the bottom, and I'll hold the flower to the frame as I coil the weaving wire around the frame and tie the two pieces together. Once I have one side secure, I can go and secure the other side. And I'll finish this up with 3 coils. All right, now we can oxidize. And here's our finished bookmark. And just to demonstrate it for you. So this pattern is really versatile. Basically, you can do anything you want with whatever kind of little frame you start the bookmark with. And as you can see, you can also use a circle with a lotus flower as well. And I'll just end by showing you a variety of ways I've utilized this design. If you see anything in particular you'd like to see a tutorial on in the future, drop a comment below and I'll add it to my list. All right, guys, thanks so much for joining me today. I really hope you enjoyed this project. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you'd like to help me make more of these tutorials, please hit the like button and consider sharing on your social media because that's really what helps my channel grow. And don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. Also, if you follow me on Instagram, feel free to share pictures of your creations with me because I really love to see what my tutorials inspire. I'm also on TikTok now, so you can follow me there as well. And I just wanted to end by saying, have a fantastic day, and remember to love your neighbor as yourself, and in all things, treat others as you want to be treated, for this is the law and the prophets. God bless you guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.